Situation report.
We're all secure in Sector 7.
Hey, everybody. Shug here. Take a look at the tarp here. Last night it was kind of windy out here with me and Pizza, and I had this wind coming from the direction behind you. Turn around and look. Okay. And it was coming down here and hitting this hill and kind of coming up this way, but mainly hitting right here. So I put my little short tarp with my ends cut in a lot, and it worked really good. You can see here, I got them kind of folded in, just sort of crisscrossed. And that was enough to break that wind out of there for me. 11-foot ridge line. That's the part going right across here. This side, 3 feet. 3 feet on the other side. A total of 6 feet. What is it? Tell me. Nope. It's 11 by 6. Now, when I made this thing, I put a pretty high cat cut on it. Probably didn't need to do that, but it did, so there you go. All right, let's take a look at the back. Okay, pop quiz. What are the dimensions of this tarp? That's right. 11 by 6. 3 feet on each side. Now, this end I had open, because we still got permafrost on the ground here, and it's really hard to get stakes in the ground, believe you me. I had my weather shield on my hammock last night. I'll talk about that in just a second. I'm going to show it to you. And slept great. Now, a couple of things I didn't touch on. You see Pete's over there putting his stuff away. And I'm getting ready to put mine away in these snake skins over here. And I've got sil nylon snake skins. I don't care if you use mesh or sil nylon or wad your tarp in a bag. When you get home, hang that thing up and let it air out for a day or two. Needs to be completely dry. Don't forget that.
Well, campers, got the old weather shield deployed here. Now, all the weather shield is a piece of ripstop nylon that just hangs up underneath my hammock here. So when I'm laying in, because I'm using my smaller tarp, I try to keep that wind in this cold weather off my underquilt. It keeps a little bit of heat in, totally warms it up, because it breaks the wind hitting my hammock and just robbing that nice heat you got going. Mine weighs 7 ounces. I just made it myself. Looks like this. And it just wads away right back here into my black bishop bag. But having it on this cooler, windy weather is really nice. And it would also, on a short tarp, it would keep some rain splash. If you really had a blowing rain, it would just keep mist and fog off of your underquilt as well. Speaking of underquilts, this is my winter Yeti. And the last time I camped in this very same spot about 2 weeks ago, and I'd gotten a little bit of a cold butt. Might have been due to the cold medicine I was taking. But it's got so much down in it that on this channel suspension, meaning that I've got a piece of shock cord running from one end of the hammock to the other, and I can slide this underquilt to make adjustments back and forth on it. Well, I added 2 tabs to it. All right, one is hooked right up here on my ridge line. The other one, when I get in the hammock, I pull that up, and when I'm laying in the hammock, that keeps this hooked up right around me. Let's get a close-in look on that. All right, right here I just have a grogain loop sewed in at the very tippy top of the channel on my winter Yeti. So it's not affecting the slide of the shock cord at all. Then I just have a piece of shock cord going up, and this is the side I get in and out, so I'm using one of these just hook loops. I can just hook right in. And on the other side, I have a mitten hook that I can hook to the ridge line to stay. And that really just brings that thing up right around my buttocks. And I have not had a cold buttocks at all since I have utilized this technique. But I think this whole new technology of these winter underquilts with having this much down in them, I don't know, I just think the shock cord starts to sag, and I think it sags more in cold weather. Just a theory?
I will continue the testing, and it will never end as long as I am alive, the Shug, who talks about himself in third person as much as possible.
As far as sleeping in a hammock, the rule of thumb is around 70 degrees, 75, 65, you're going to need something under you. But really, just get out and start doing it. Have some fun. It's the journey and the trip. The exploration, the research, the trials, the tribulations, the ups and downs, the jubilation, the degradation. These are all the things that make it fun. Otherwise, you just might want to stick to your tent, and that's fine too. I don't even really want to talk about that. Camp is set.
and I'm ready to hunker down for the night. I think we got infiltrators. It's the pass-through. Checking out the backside.
Well, good morning, everybody. It's old sleepyhead Shug here. I just woke up, had a glorious night. Got to be about 32 degrees last night, and I slept real well. It was windy. Man, not a cold spot on me. Totally warm. Well, we've got the old breakfast from the hammock going here. Using my boots as a wind block. I've got my hillbilly pot on. Using the bush buddy with the mini atomic in it, and it is firing away. Get that coffee stir. Oh ho 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 ho. Yeah.
Well, the people out there. Hello, everybody. My name's Shug. I'm out for a little two-nighter here. I'm on my way out back to my car. I'm going to drive up about 50 miles and go to another undisclosed location. I've got a pretty light load in here on my ULA Catalyst backpack. You can see out here there's just bits of snow around and a lot of mud, and the ground is hard. And I'm up on a high ridge, so there's no water. So I was melting some nasty snow with a lot of dirt and poop in it. All right, that's my report for now. Excellent briefing. We'll reconvene at 1400 hours. Out of here.
We're looking at the Warbonnet Superfly with the doors added on. He's got a door right there, and I'm going to circle around and not a door there. This is a really cool tarp. It's got the pullouts added to it, which is quite handy. You love those, don't you?
Very nice. Yep.
You got a ton of room. I mean, that is a cavernous space. And you got the Blackbird, three season Yeti, and you're sleeping in the JRB, what, Old Mountain Rag?
Yep. Old Mountain.
Oh, the old, what is it, Old Rag Mountain?
Yep.
That old Rag Mountain, it just keeps going. It's going, going. I'm very tired, walking and humping to the top of Old Rag Mountain. See, that didn't have to rhyme. It didn't all have to rhyme. I'm not Dr. Seuss. So you weren't cold at all in that, were you?
Not at all.
Yo, what up, everybody? It's old Shug coming to you here, having a little breakfast on the hammock out here, talking to pizza. My old buddy for hammock forms. I'm going to stick the camera out there and see if I can see him somewhere. You out there, man?
I am.
That's pizza right there, everybody. And you can probably see his rig right over there. I cut his head off there. He's over there through the fog. Looking good, man. You happy to be outside?
You bet.
Yeah, we hanging out here in the backwood hood. All right, peace out, y'all. You can see I got my doors down there in the end, kind of closed in. We had some wind last night. Opened back here because the wind was coming from down toward my feet. And this is my packa that I just used its clips and hung it on my ridgeline. And when I'm laying here, I can keep a bunch of stuff down in this pouch. And it just keeps that wind from coming up that hill off my face. It was a genius moment for me. Worked good. I did it the last two nights. Worked good both times. Okay then, that's all I got to say about that. What I've hoped to do here is inspire you to get out and just get into this stuff and just start doing it. All right, I've said that.
Thank you, and I bid you adieu.
I need you to go on recon, set out a listening post. Did you get that?
Morris is more of the wordsmith. I write the tunes.
Because I'm telling you right here, so just focus on the video.
Hey man, y'all get out of my campsite.
Hi there, my name's Shug. Shugity Shug 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 Shug. I'm gonna have to keep it down and low.
Ta-ta for now.